Hey teachers, have you ever tried to share a Google slide with students in your class? And what happens is when one student types something in, what they put on their Google slide shows up on everybody's slide. If you've ever run into this problem, I'm going to show you how to solve it. So the way that I explain this problem to teachers is it's very similar to when you go to a copy machine with a hard copy of a worksheet that you want students to complete. You make one copy of the worksheet for every single student in your class, and then you keep the master copy so that it never changes from year to year. Basically, what you want to do with your Google Slide is exactly the same thing. You want to create a hard copy that you can keep the same from year to year, but you want to make copies for each of your students. So let's jump on my computer and I'm going to show you how you can create copies of your Google Slides. So this is my Civil Rights Movement Digital Passages and Questions, which is part of my U.S. History Digital Passage Bundle. So let's say I want to share this passage and the questions that go with it with my students. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click share the same way that I normally would, and I'm just going to copy that link. Now, I always recommend that people work in Google Chrome whenever you're working with any Google app, but if you want to test something and see what it looks like from the student's view, just open another browser to test whatever you're working within. So I've got another browser here, and I'm going to paste that link that I just copied. And what I'm gonna do, whenever you have a slide, you'll see like presentation and then a whole bunch of letters and numbers, and then you'll see a backslash. Usually it will say edit, and then you'll see some additional stuff here. Whatever is after that backslash, after you have all these letters and numbers, you want to get rid of this. So delete it and type in copy. You're gonna see you get this screen here, and it's going to say make a copy. So you'll just direct your students to click on that, and when they do, they will open a copy of the document or the slides. So whatever they type in on the response here, so I can type in anything here, and if I go back to my original document or my original slide, you will see that this did not change. So remember, all you're going to do is after you have all these letters and numbers, get rid of whatever is behind the backslash and change it to copy. It's that simple. So I hope this tip helps solve a problem that you might be experiencing with Google Slides right now. And if you're looking for even more tech tips, make sure to download my free guide all about using technology to teach. You can find the link in the description of this video. Also, leave a comment and let me know how you are using Google Slides in your classroom. And don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel so that you never miss out on any teaching tips. Happy teaching!